Dear students, today's lecture is on construction of Tanabe-Sugano diagrams. So for Tanabe-Sugano diagrams, we have already studied about the Racker parameters, Neflox-Zeitig ratio, Neflox-Zeitig effects. So in this lecture, I will discuss about these simple configurations like D1, D2, D3, D8 and D9. So how we can construct the Tanabe-Sugano diagrams of these simple configurations which have this similar type of splitting either in high spin as well as in low spin complexes. So first of all, we will start with the D1 configuration. So in case of D1 configuration, it is just like orgel diagram, but the difference is that at y-axis, we have to plot this E upon B, and in the x-axis, we have to write delta O upon B. Instead of delta O and E, we have to write E upon B and delta O upon B. So this is a plot between E upon B. B is Racker parameter, and here also B is Racker parameter. So the plot between E upon B and delta O upon B is Tanabe-Sugano diagram, and in this diagram we can see that we have already calculated the ground state term for D1 configuration. I will show you that in case of this configuration, because this orbital has plus 2 m value, this has 1, this has minus 1, this has 0, minus 1 and minus 2. So this electron is in plus 2 orbital, so its L will become 2 and its S will become half, because there is only one unpaired electron. So due to L, the state will be D, and due to half, its multiplicity will become 2. So ground state term will be 2D. When it is either it is high spin complex or it is low spin complex, the electron will remain in plus 2 ml orbital, and this ground state will not be changed. So in case of D1 configuration, this ground state will remain as such. It is weak field or it is strong field complex, this remains 2D. So this is weak field complex, and as we go from left to right, the crystal field is splitting increasing, because delta O is increasing, so crystal field is splitting energy increasing. So from here to here, this is weak field complex, and we are going from weak field to strong field complex. So we can see that the orgel diagram as well as the Tanabe-Sugano diagram of D1 configuration, they are almost similar, but the difference is that it is the plot in between E upon B and delta O upon B. And the next difference point is that its 2D is the free ion term, and when complex formation takes place, after complex formation, after octahedral complex formation, we can see that this is the horizontal line. So it is zero energy level, and at this, the ground state term of the complex, octahedral complex, that is 2T2G, because we can see that T2G is asymmetrically filled. So this term will be T, and the other term, that is excited state, where the electron will excite it to the EG orbital, now E is asymmetrically filled, the state will be EG. So we can see that this is the ground state term, 2T2G, and 2EG is the excited state term. So that this is the Tanabe-Sugano diagram, which is almost similar to that of orgel diagram, but there are two differences, that it is the plot between E upon B and delta O upon B, and the horizontal line is the ground state term. So we can also suggest that these Tanabe-Sugano diagrams, that can be drawn only for octahedral complexes, because tetrahedral complexes, they are always high spin complexes. So orgel diagrams and the Tanabe-Sugano diagrams for tetrahedral complexes, they are almost similar. So we can see that here also only one transition is possible. So in case of D1 configuration, always it may be weak field complex or it may be high spin complex. Always there will be possibility of only one transition, that is from T2G to EG. So only one peak will be observed in the Tanabe-Sugano diagram, in the electronic spectra of this D1 configuration transition metal complex. Now we will move to the configurations which are again, which have the similar type of ground state term in high spin as well as in low spin complex. So this is D2 configuration. In case of D2 configuration, we have already studied that the ground state term of a free metal ion is 3F, and after formation of octahedral complex, F term is split into these three terms, that is T1G, 3T2G and 3A2G. So this ground state term of this octahedral complex will be present at the horizontal line. Its configuration is T2G2, and then the energy of 3T2G, that is T2G1, EG1. We have already discussed how this T1G term originates. I can again explain. This is the configuration of ground state configuration of D2 configuration, and we have discussed in the lecture on ground state term of transition metal complexes that this kind of configuration, it is known as T1G. So if there are two unpaired electrons in D2 configuration, then the ground state term will be T1G. So this is T1G, then it's the other term is T2G and the other term is 3T2G. These three terms are of F, and this term is originated from T1G from P. So this is T1G of P, and T1G and T2G, they have the similar configuration. We have already discussed in orbital diagrams. So they have the similar type of configurations, that is T2G1, EG1. They arises from these two configurations because their degeneracy is 6, 3 and 2. 3, 2, 6. So their degeneracy is 6. So 3 degeneracy in T1G and 3 degeneracy in T2G. So this is the orbital diagram. You can again see, because in high spin complex the configuration will remain the same, and in low spin complex that will be the configuration of D2 configuration. So the Tanabe-Sugano diagram of D2 complex will be similar to that of orbital diagram, but the difference, there are two main differences, that this is the plot in between delta O upon V and E upon V, and the ground state term will be the horizontal line in case of Tanabe-Sugano diagram. Now in case of D3 configuration, we can see that this the ground state term of free metal ion is 4F. So 4F will split into the ground state term in octahedral complex will be A2G. So it is 4A2G, then the next term is 4T2G, then T1G and then T1G of P. So this is again for D3 configuration, we can see that the electronic configuration of D3 will be the same either for high spin complex or for low spin complex. So the Tanabe-Sugano diagram for weak field as well as for strong field complex will be similar. So this is similar, but to the octahedral orbital diagrams, but it is different by the value, the plotting values, that are E upon B and delta O upon B, and the ground state term will be the horizontal line. So we can see in this case that T1G and T1G both are the same symmetry terms with the same multiplicity. So again, through correlation diagram, we have studied that when the two states of same multiplicity, same symmetry, they will mix. After mixing, the energy of the lower state will decrease. This will stabilize further, and the energy of the higher energy state will increase and it will destabilize. So they never cross each other. So this is non-crossing rule here also. In Tanabe-Sugano diagrams also, this will followed. This will be followed, the non-crossing rule, and according to non-crossing rule, the same symmetry terms, they never cross each other. While in case of D2 configuration, you have seen that T1G and A2G, they can cross each other, but here they cannot cross each other. So in this diagram, we can see that this the ground state term will be the horizontal line. So only this is the difference in between orbital diagram of D3 configuration and Tanabe-Sugano diagram of D3 configuration. Now in the case of D8 configuration, because D8 configuration is just like D3 configuration, only difference is the multiplicity. So here the multiplicity is 3 and there the multiplicity was 4. And in this case the configuration will be changed. Rest of the diagram is similar to that of D3 configuration. Now in case of D9 configuration also, we can see that the filling of electrons will be same in case of strong field complex as well as in case of weak field complex. No difference will be there. So this will be the configuration of D9. So T2G6 and EG3, that will remain the same either the case of strong field or the case of weak field. So in this case also it looks like that of orgel diagram, but the difference is that it is the plot between E upon B and delta O upon B, and the ground state term will be the horizontal line. So we can see that in D9 configuration also, in case of octahedral orgel diagrams also, the lower energy state was EG and higher energy state was T2G. So again we can see that there is a possibility of one transition in this case. So only one peak will be observed in case of D9 configuration. Either it may be strong field complex or maybe weak field complex, always it will show only one peak in the spectra, in its spectra. But in case of, again I am going back to the configurations that are D2 configuration. So in case of D2 configuration, D3 configuration and D8 configuration, we can see that there is possibility of 3 peaks in the electronic spectra due to these 3 transitions. In Tanabe-Sugano diagram also, it can explain that either a weak field complex or a strong field complex, in both cases there is possibility of 3 transitions. So 3 peaks appears in case of D2, D3 and D8 configuration, because there is 1 ground state and 3 excited states. So there are possibilities of 3 transitions. And we can see that the Tanabe-Sugano diagrams, they also follow the similar selection rules, that are spin selection rule. So the electrons will transit from the state of same multiplicity. So from 3 to 3, from 3 to 3, from 3 to 3. So spin multiplicity will, selection rule will be maintained in Tanabe-Sugano diagrams also. In the next lecture, we will discuss the Tanabe-Sugano diagrams of the configurations that have ground state term different in weak field complex and different in strong field complexes, and those configurations are D4, D5, D6 and D7. Especially these 4 configurations, they have different type of orgel diagrams from that of orgel diagrams.
Thank you very much. If you like this video, please like, subscribe.